Hello students, welcome to AIIMS India online classes. This is a chemistry session. Here we are discussing about the chapter chemical bonding. In this session especially we are going to see a new concept that is called valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, VSEPR theory it is commonly called, so which is abbreviated as valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, which explains us about the shape of the molecules and the bond angles present in the molecule with multi-atomic molecules. Okay, let us see about this concept. Valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, which is also said to be VSEPR theory. So in this, valence shell electron pair repulsion model of molecular shapes is a simple extension of Lewis ideas. In the earlier sessions, we have seen how molecules are represented by using Lewis dot structures, isn't it? Now you can say this valence shell electron pair repulsion theory is just an extension to this Lewis ideas, and is surprisingly successful for predicting the shapes of the polyatomic molecules. So by using this theory, we can predict the shapes of the polyatomic molecules. Sedgwick and Powell proposed that for molecules and ions which are having only single bonds, an approximate shape can be predicted from the number of electron pairs in the valence shell of the central atom. So these two scientists, they have proposed that for the molecules in which they are having completely single bonds, then the shape of that molecule can be predicted based upon the number of electron pairs present on the central atom of that molecule, based upon the electron pairs present in the on the central atom of that molecule, the shape of that molecule can be predicted by using this theory. The outer shell of the central atom of a molecule may contain one or more bond pairs of electrons and even also lone pairs of electrons. See here, ammonia molecule is represented. In this ammonia molecule, nitrogen central atom, nitrogen, it has three bond pairs of electrons. We know what is meant by bond pair, the pair of electrons which are participating in the bond formation. Here if you see, between nitrogen and hydrogen, a pair of electrons there which are participating in the bond formation, that is called bond pair. In this way, there are three pairs of electrons participating in the bond formation. So these three are called bond pairs. And if you see, there is one more pair of electrons on the nitrogen, which is present in the valence shell but not participating in the bond formation. Such kind of pairs of electrons which are present in the valence shell but not participating in the bond formation are called as lone pairs of electrons. So in this way, in a molecule, the central atom may contain one or more bond pairs and even lone pairs of electrons also. Bond pairs and lone pairs were expected as equivalent, since all electron pairs take up some space and repel each other, isn't it? Here nitrogen has totally four pairs of electrons. These are considered or expected to be equivalent, and because these all are made up of electrons, and each pair will be having repulsion with other pairs. Okay? Repulsion is minimized between the electron pairs if these electron pairs are oriented in the space as far as possible. As far apart as possible. So, based upon this concept, the shape of the molecule is predicted based upon the repulsions between the pairs of electrons present on the central atom. So here, because of the repulsions existing between these electron pairs, these pairs of electrons will try to orient in the space as far as possible from one to another. Thus, they take the space around the central atom to minimize the repulsions between the electron pairs. Gillips and Nyholm improved the theory to predict and explain the molecular shapes and bond angles more exactly. So these two scientists, they have improved this concept of valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. to predict and explain the molecular shapes and bond angles more exactly. Okay. Now let us see the postulates of this valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. What it explains. The shapes of the molecule. The shape of the molecule is determined by the repulsions between the all electron pairs that are present in the valence shell of the central atom of that molecule. So based upon the electron pairs present in the valence shell of that atom, which is considered as central atom of that molecule, based upon that, the shape and bond angles present in the molecule can be predicted. Okay. A lone pair of electrons takes up more space around the central atom than a bond pair, because the lone pair is attracted to the molecule. Okay, see here, what is explained here? A lone pair will take more space around the central atom than a bond pair, because this lone pair is attracted to only one nucleus, to this atom only, to the central atom only, isn't it? Whereas a bond pair is shared by two nuclei. If you see this molecule, it is a central atom, we can consider as this is central atom. And here, two atoms are connected, X and Y. Now, this pair of electrons is completely attracted to the only one nucleus. So, it will be having more repulsion and it will take more space around the nucleus. Whereas, these two pairs are located between two nuclei. These are shared by two nuclei and hence, they exhibit less repulsion when compared to lone pair repulsion. That's why the repulsion because of lone pair is greater than the repulsion because of bonded pair. So this also to be considered while predicting the shape of the molecule. So it follows that repulsion between two lone pairs is greater than the repulsion between a lone pair and a bond pair, which is in turn is greater than the repulsion between two bonded pairs. Okay, based upon this concept, it is given the order of repulsions. It is said that here, the repulsion between two lone pairs is greater than the repulsion between bond pair and lone pair, which is in turn greater than the repulsion between two bonded pairs. So based upon this, they take up the space around the central atom. Okay. The presence of lone pairs on the central atom causes slight distortion of the bond angles from the ideal shape. So if there are only a bond pairs, they take up the shape, they take up the space around the nucleus in the equal distances to overcome the repulsions between these bonded pairs. But if there existing at least one lone pair, so the presence of lone pairs on the central atom causes slight distortion of the bonded angles, because lone pair causes more repulsion than the bonded pair just now we have seen. So because of this reason, there will be slight distortion in the bond angles in the shape expected from the ideal shape. Okay, if the angle between a lone pair and a central atom and a bond pair is increased, it follows that the actual bond angle between the atoms must be decreased. So what happens here, as the presence of lone pair, because of this lone pair, repulsion is greater than the bond pair repulsions, and hence there will be a slight distortion in the bond angle and shape. So now the bond angle between lone pair and bond pair is increased. Then what happens? There will be decrease in the bond angle between bond pair and bond pair, and hence we can say the bond angle in the molecule with the central atom lone pairs will be decreased than the ideal case. Okay. The magnitude of repulsions between the bonding pairs of electrons depends on the electronegativity difference between the central atom and the other atoms. So here one more point which is affecting the shape of the molecules is the type of atoms participating in the bond formation. The magnitude of repulsion between bonding pairs of electrons, it depends upon the electronegativity difference between the central atom and the bonded atoms. And one more point it is, which is affecting the shape of the molecule, is multiple bonds. Double bonds cause more repulsion than single bonds. And triple bonds cause more repulsion than double bonds. So in between two atoms, if there is a double bond and the other side if there is one single bond, the repulsion because of this double bond is greater than the repulsion because of single bond. In turn, the repulsion because of this triple bond will be greater than the repulsion because of double bond. Multiple bonds between two atoms count the same as single bond in predicting the shape. Yes, while predicting the shape, a multiple bond between two atoms will be considered as a single bond, because it does not matter how many electrons present in the each direction. So how many number of atoms might be there between two atoms, but it will be considered as one bond while predicting the shape of the molecule. In studying molecular geometry, it is convenient to divide different molecules into two categories. So while predicting the shape of the molecules and bond angles, it is better to segregate all the molecules into two different categories. One of them is molecules in which the central atom has no lone pairs, means that the central atom will be considering to be having only bond pairs of electrons around its nucleus, no lone pairs. For example, molecules like BeCl2, observe here the central atom is beryllium and it has two valence electrons. These two are participating in the bond formation of the two fluorine atoms, and hence beryllium has only two bond pairs of electrons but no lone pairs, isn't it? In the same way, if you observe boron trifluoride, BF3, in this molecule also the central atom is boron, which is connected with three fluorine atoms, and hence boron has three bond pairs of electrons around its nucleus but no lone pairs of electrons in its valence shell. In the similar way, the remaining molecules also you can see. Carbon in methane molecule in CH4, it has only four bond pairs of electrons, no lone pairs, isn't it? In the same PCl5, phosphorus has five bond pairs, no lone pairs. You can see here one more, sulfur hexafluoride, SF6. In this molecule also, sulfur has six bond pairs and no lone pairs. So this is one category. While trying to predict the shape and bond angles of molecules, it is convenient if we segregate the molecules like this into two categories. One, it is the molecules with the central atom having only bond pairs of electrons without lone pairs. And the second category is the molecules in which the central atom has one or more lone pairs also along with bond pairs. For example, sulfur dioxide, SO2. What is the central atom in this molecule? Sulfur. We know its atomic number is 16 and its configuration is 2, 8, 6. Means the central atom in this sulfur dioxide molecule has totally 6 valence electrons, isn't it? Now it is connected with 2 oxygen atoms. With each oxygen atom, it forms a double bond here. First, with one single oxygen, it forms a double bond. Now, this oxygen is getting octet configuration. At the same time, the sulfur also attained octet configuration by this double bond. Now, with another oxygen atom, it forms a dative bond. We have seen what is meant by a dative bond already, isn't it? Now, this is a molecular shape. Now, these two bonds are considered as a single bond while predicting the shape of this molecule. And this is one bond. Totally, it has two bond pairs now while predicting the shape. Even though it is double bond, it is considered as a single bond while predicting the shape. Because whatever the number of electrons shared between two atoms, they will be having only one direction between these two atoms. So these multiple bonds are also considered as a single bond while predicting the shape. Now, it has, apart from these bond pairs, sulfur atom is also having a pair of electrons in its valence shell which are not participating in the bond formation. See here these two. So, these pair of electrons are called as lone pairs of electrons. So, the repulsion because of these lone pairs is greater than the repulsion because of these bond pairs. Okay, that's why there will be distortion, slight distortion in its bond angle as well as in the shape also. That's why we consider these molecules which are having at least one lone pair of electrons on its central atom. In the same way, if you observe ammonia molecule, in the ammonia molecule also, the central atom is nitrogen. It has 5 valence electrons. Out of 5, 3 electrons are participating in the bond formation with 3 hydrogen atoms. So, in that way, nitrogen will get 3 bond pairs of electrons around its nucleus. Along with these 3 bond pairs, there is one more pair of electrons which we call as lone pair. So, because of this lone pair, there will be a slight distortion in its bond angle as well as shape. If there is a, there are only 3 bond pairs of electrons around the nucleus, then the shape can be predicted very easily because all our bond pairs, they will maintain equal distance from one to another in the space, and hence bond can be, or shape can be predicted easily. But here, as it is having one more lone pair of electrons also on the central atom nitrogen, the repulsion because of this lone pair will be greater when compared to the repulsions between these three. So, there will be a slight distortion in its shape. So, that's why these kind of molecules which are having at least one lone pair of electrons on its central atom are categorized separately. So, in this way, the molecules, all the molecules, if they are segregated into two categories, like the molecules without lone pairs on the central atom and the molecules with at least one lone pair of electrons on its central atom. Now we can predict the molecular shapes and geometry conveniently. Okay. Now let us start predicting the shapes of the molecules without any lone pairs on the central atom. See the first one. The molecule with two bond pairs and no lone pairs. See here the first number indicating the bond pairs and the second number indicating the lone pairs of electrons on its central atom. So if a molecule, if it is having only two bond pairs, no lone pairs, then what happens? These two bond pairs will try to repel each other, and they maintain maximum distance one to another to overcome the repulsions. And hence, the geometry will be linear for that molecule. So the molecule exists in this shape, like this. Suppose it is a central atom. These two are the bonded atoms. We can say these two are bond pairs. Now, these two will maintain maximum distance one to another, and hence the molecule comes into linear shape. Then the bond angle will be 180 degrees. Got it? Now, some molecules which are having these two bond pairs, no lone pairs, means the molecule with the linear shape is carbon dioxide. See here, the central atom is carbon. It is connected with the two oxygen atoms. Now, there are no lone pairs on the carbon atom. As we told, these multiple bonds are considered as single bond while predicting the shape. Because wherever this oxygen moves, all pairs of electrons will be moved along with the oxygen in single direction. Isn't it? That's why these pair of electrons all together considered as a bond. Now, these two will repel each other and will maintain maximum distance one to another, and hence it comes to linear shape. If it is linear shape, what is the bond angle? 180 degrees. Can you say in some other molecules which are having only two bond pairs, no lone pairs? Very nice. Just now we have seen here, that is BeCl2, beryllium chloride, BeF2, beryllium difluoride or beryllium fluoride. In these all molecules, central atom has only two bond pairs without lone pairs. And hence, these all molecules let acquire linear shape and they have bond angle 180 degrees. Okay. In this way, the shape is predicted based upon the repulsions between the lone pairs and bond pairs present on the central atom of the molecules. Now let us see another kind. The molecule with three bond pairs and no lone pairs. If there are three bond pairs, these three bond pairs will be considered as equivalent and each will maintain maximum distance from one to another with the equal force to overcome the repulsions. Then the shape will be trigonal planar. The molecule will be existing in this way. This is called trigonal planar shape. It is central atom and the three bond pairs will maintain maximum distance from one to another, and hence it acquires a shape called trigonal planar shape. In this shape, the bond angle will be 120 degrees. And some examples for the molecules having this shape are BCl3, boron trichloride, boron trifluoride, BF3. So in these molecules, the central atom has AlCl3. In these molecules, central atom has only three bond pairs of electrons and no lone pairs. Okay, such kind of molecules acquire the shape called trigonal planar shape, where the bond angle is 120 degrees. Let us see another. The molecule with four bond pairs and no lone pairs. Then these four bond angles acquire a shape called tetrahedron shape. Okay, and the molecule will be seen like this. Four bonds will maintain equal distance from one to another and they spread in the space, in three-dimensional space. That is, arrangement is called tetrahedron shape. There, the bond angle between the molecule, between two bonds will be 109 degrees 28 minutes. So around 30 minutes it is. That's why it is mentioned here 109.5 minutes. Nothing but 109 degrees 30 minutes average. But actually it is, to say accurately, 109 degrees 28 minutes. The example for the molecule with the tetrahedron shape is CCl4 or methane. See here, the central atom is carbon. It has no lone pairs on the central atom, only four bond pairs. So these will maintain equal distance from one to another in the space and attains tetrahedron shape with bond angle 109 degrees 28 minutes. Okay, let us see another example. The molecule with five bond pairs, no lone pairs. There are five bond pairs. If they maintain maximum distance from one to another to overcome the repulsions, then they attain a shape called, geometry called, trigonal bipyramidal shape. This is called, first three bond pairs will maintain the same plane with a trigonal planar shape and one bond pair will be above the plane and another will be below the plane. This shape is called trigonal bipyramidal shape. If you consider these three atoms, these are on the same plane. It is in the above the plane. From the above the plane, if you observe, it is like a trigonal pyramidal shape. From the bottom also, trigonal pyramidal shape is existing. That's why this shape is called trigonal bipyramidal shape. So in this shape, there are existing two kinds of bond angles. If you see here, within the plane, between these atoms, in the trigonal planar shape, bond angle will be 120 degrees. And one atom is there above the plane. Here the bond angle will be 90 degrees. So, in the trigonal bipyramidal shaped molecules, there exist two kinds of bond angles. Within the plane, 120 degrees. And above and below the plane, they maintain 90 degrees. Okay. Examples for the molecules having this trigonal bipyramidal shape are PCl5, PF5, which we call as phosphorus pentafluoride or phosphorus pentachloride. These molecules have only five bond pairs of electrons on the central atom phosphorus without any lone pairs. And thus, the molecular geometry will be trigonal bipyramidal shape with bond angles 120 and 90 degrees. Okay, next kind, next category, the molecules with six bond pairs, no lone pairs. There are six bond pairs. Then the geometry of the molecule will be octahedron. It can be represented like this. So, four bond pairs will be maintained in the same plane along with the central atom. And one will be above the plane, the other will be below the plane. So in this shape, all the bond pairs will maintain equal distance from one to another in all the directions you can observe. So here, between any two bond pairs, the bond angle will be 90 degrees. So this shape is called octahedron. And the molecule, example molecule for the molecule which is having this octahedron shape with the six bond pairs and no lone pairs on the central atom, we can say as SF6, sulfur hexafluoride it is called. In this central atom, is sulfur has only six bond pairs without any lone pairs. So these bond pairs will maintain equal distance from each other and they acquire a geometry called octahedron with bond angles 90 degrees. Okay, another kind, the molecules with seven bond pairs but no lone pairs. There are seven bond pairs, then the geometry of the molecule will be pentagonal bipyramidal. Means there will be five bond pairs in the same plane along with the central atom. See here it is mentioned a pentagonal shape. So these bond pairs, five bond pairs are there in the same plane along with the central atom. And there is one bond pair above the plane and there is one more below the plane. So from the top, if it is seen, it will be like a pentagonal pyramidal shape. From the bottom also, pentagonal pyramidal shape is existing. That's why this shape is called pentagonal bipyramidal shape. Okay, it is called pentagonal bipyramidal shape. Here also, just like the trigonal bipyramidal shape, two bond angles are existing within the plane and above and below the plane. If you see, within the plane, five bond pairs are there divided by 360 total divide. Equal distance, no? That's why, if you see, within the plane, the bond angle will be 72 degrees between any two bond pairs within the plane. It will be 72 degrees. And above and below the plane, if you see here, above and below the plane, there exists 90 degrees because it is perpendicular to the plane of the geometry. So here the bond angle is 90 degrees. In this way, in the molecules which are having pentagonal bipyramidal shape, there exist two bond angles. One within the plane between the bond pairs, the bond angle will be 72 degrees. And above and below the planes, the bond angle will be 90 degrees. Now, the example molecule which is having this geometry, pentagonal bipyramidal shape, is IF7 or zirconium F7 ion. So, in this, the central atom will be having seven bond pairs without any lone pairs. One more molecule you can see, that is IF7. In that also, the central atom will be having only seven bond pairs without lone pairs. So, for these all molecules, the prediction of bond angle and shape is somewhat easy because all are of same kind of bond pairs. So, the repulsion between these all will be symmetry. So, the symmetry we can observe in the molecular shape. But in the second category, means that the molecules in which the central atoms are having at least one or more lone pairs also along with the bond pairs, then there occurs certain slight distortion in their geometry which is expected to be. Let us see those now. The molecule with two bond pairs and one lone pair. If a molecule is having only two bond pairs, what we have seen, the shape of the molecule is being linear. But as the presence of one lone pair, that will push the two bond pairs down, because we learned that lone pair repulsion is much greater than the repulsion because of bond pairs. So the geometry of the molecule will be bent or angular. So we can say molecular shape like this. So actually, these white balls represents the bond pair. This yellow ball represents here a lone pair. Now actually, if there are only two bond pairs, the shape is predicted as linear. But because of this lone pair, these two bond pairs are pushed down. Because its repulsion is greater on these. It pushes these two bond pairs down much. They come a little close. Okay, now the bond angle for these molecules will be around 119 degrees 3 minutes. Of course, this also may vary based upon the type of atoms participating in the bond formation. Okay, it is will be around 120 or 119 degrees around. Example for the molecules having this kind of geometry are sulfur dioxide. In this molecule, the central atom sulfur has a lone pair along with the two bond pairs. Why two bond pairs means multiple bonds are also considered as here single bonds while predicting the shape. So in this, even though sulfur has double bonds, this is considered as one bond pair. This is one bond pair and it is a lone pair. Okay. That's about the molecule with two bond pairs and one lone pair. Let us see another kind of molecules. That is the molecules with two bond pairs and two lone pairs on the central atom. So these two lone pairs will cause more repulsion and hence the shape will be here also bent or angular, but the angle of bending will be more. The molecular shape can be represented like this. So these two bond pair push it some more because of the existence of two lone pairs on the central atom. Then the bond angle will be around 104 degrees 5 minutes. The example for the molecule having this kind of geometry, that means with two bond pairs and two lone pairs on the central atom with the bent shape, is a water molecule. Very familiar molecule to us. It is water molecule. See, in the water molecule, the central atom oxygen has two bond pairs, the two hydrogen atoms, and there are two lone pairs also. So the repulsion because of these lone pairs is much greater. So they push this bond pairs down and hence the bond shape will be bent or angle, which is also considered as V shape. You can see here we inverted V shape, right? So it is called V shape, where the bond angle is considered as 104 degrees 5 minutes. Okay. Now let us see another kind. That is the molecule with two bond pairs and three lone pairs. Now the shape will be linear because in this way three lone pairs on the central atom will acquire a trigonal planar shape in the space, whereas the remaining two bond pairs will come above and below the plane of this. Now the shape of the molecule is considered from the bonded pairs, isn't it? Now this is linear shape and bond angle will be here 180 degrees. And the molecules with this linear shape, example will be xenon difluoride, XeF2. In this molecule, xenon has three lone pairs of electrons and two bond pairs. Now, these three lone pairs will come into a plane, with a trigonal planar shape. But we consider the shape based upon the bond pairs only. So, above this plane of lone pairs, there is one bond pair, and below the plane, there is one bond pair. So, we can say, this is the shape of the molecule, linear shape. And here the bond angle is 180 degrees. Okay. Now another molecules. The molecules with three bond pairs and one lone pair. If there are only three bond pairs, what the shape we expected? We can expect the shape as trigonal planar shape. But because of the presence of one lone pair on the central atom, it pushes down the three pairs of electrons. And hence it acquires a shape called trigonal pyramidal shape in this way. So this lone pair pushes these three pairs of electrons down and hence they come into a pyramidal shape, which is called trigonal pyramidal shape. Here the bond angle will be 107 degrees. Actually, if there are only three bond pairs of electrons, then the bond angle is expected to be 120 degrees. But because of this existence of lone pair, they are pushed down and they are being with the bond angle 107 degrees. An example molecule for this kind of shape or geometry is ammonia. In the ammonia molecule, central atom nitrogen has three bond pairs of electrons and one lone pair. And hence it is in the shape called, geometry called trigonal pyramidal shape with bond angle 107 degrees. Okay. Next, the molecule with three bond pairs and two lone pairs on the central atom, then the shape will be expected to be T shape. This is the shape we say. Here, this pink one is a central atom. These three bonded pairs will come into the T shape. See here, in this way. And where the two lone pairs are occupying the above space. This shape is called T shape. And here the bond angle is being here 190 degrees. And between these two bond pairs, 180 degrees. So two types of bond angles are existing in the molecules with the geometry T-shaped geometry, 90 degrees and 180 degrees. And the molecule, example molecule with this T-shaped geometry is a chlorine trifluoride, ClF3. In this molecule, central atom chlorine is with three bond pairs and two lone pairs. So these three bond pairs will come into this T-shape. See, this is T-shape. Isn't it? Now, this shape is called T-shape, and the bond angle in this molecule, if you see between these two bond pairs, bond angle is 90 degrees, and between these two, the bond angle will be 180 degrees. Okay? Now, another kind. The molecule with four bond pairs and one lone pair. So, then the shape of the molecule will be seesaw. This is the way. So it is like a seesaw. See here, isn't it? This is called a seesaw shape, and the lone pair will come to above the plane here, in the upper direction. And then the bond angle in this molecule, if you see here, the bond angle, it is perpendicular to this, actually it is three-dimensional picture. Here, the bond angle will be 90 degrees, and between these two, the bond angle will be 120 degrees. So this shape is called seesaw shape. An example molecule with this geometry of seesaw shape is SF4, sulfur tetrafluoride. In this molecule's central atom sulfur is with four bond pairs and one lone pair. So this is called seesaw shape. Isn't it? This is called seesaw shape with four bond pairs and one lone pair. Okay, next, another kind, four bond pairs and two lone pairs on the central atom, then the shape will be square planar. Square planar means four bond pairs will come into the same plane along with the central atom, and two lone pairs will be above and below the plane. See, it is represented here, four bond pairs on the same plane along with the central atom. One lone pair is above the plane and the another lone pair is below the plane, isn't it? Then the bond angle will be 90 degrees, because in the same plane they are existing, they maintain equal distance between any two bond pairs. The bond angle will be 90 degrees. An example for the molecule having this kind of geometry, that is square planar shape, is xenon tetrafluoride. In this xenon tetrafluoride, central atom xenon is with four bond pairs and the two lone pairs of electrons. So these four bond pairs will come into the same plane, and the remaining two lone pairs will be above and below the plane. And hence, the bond angle will be here 90 degrees. Okay. Next, another kind. The molecule with five bond pairs and one lone pair. Then the shape is expected to be square pyramidal. This is the shape. Square pyramidal, and the bond angle will be here 180 and 90 degrees. 180 means here, between these two bond pairs, if you see, between these two, the bond angle is 180 degrees. Between these two, or between these two, if you see, the bond angle is being 90 degrees. So two kinds of bond angles are existing in the molecules with the shape square pyramidal. Example for this kind of molecules, ClF5, chlorine pentafluoride. Here the central atom chlorine is with 5 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. Then 4 bond pairs are there in the same plane, and one more bond pair is above the plane. See here, above the plane, and the lone pair is existing down the plane or below the plane. Okay, this is called square pyramidal shape. Next, the molecules with five bond pairs and two lone pairs. Then the shape will be pentagonal planar shape. This is the way. If a molecule is having five bond pairs and two lone pairs, then all the five bonds will be in the same plane along with the central atom. That is called pentagonal planar shape. All in the same plane, no? Then it is called planar shape. Five corners are there. Five bond pairs are there. Then it is called pentagonal planar shape. Above and below the plane, two lone pairs will occupy the space. Then the bond angle, 360 by 5. What do we get? Bond angle is 72 degrees in this bond, in this molecule. And the example for the molecule with this shape is xenon pentafluoride ion, xenon XeF5-. In this molecule, in this ion, central atom xenon is with 5 bond pairs and 2 lone pairs of electrons totally, because it is the ion. One more electron is there. Okay. Now, in this, 5 bond pairs will be, means 5 fluorine atoms will be in the same plane along with xenon, and acquires a shape called pentagonal planar shape with bond angle 72 degrees. Okay, these are the molecules and their shapes. In this way, the molecular shapes are and bond angles are predicted based upon the bond pairs and lone pairs present on the central atom of that molecule. This is about valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, VSEPR theory it is called. Okay, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our YouTube channel AIMS Today for latest updates on recorded videos. And please visit our website aimstoday.in for the other information regarding online classes, quizzes, live worksheets, do-it-yourself activities, English classes, reasoning classes, and even coding classes.